We're now delighted to be joined over the telephone by our sports analyst, Mr. Abdulaziz Abu Hamar. A very good afternoon to you, sir.
Good afternoon to you and to everyone.
Thank you for joining us, Mr. Abdulaziz. And how do you see the performance, you know, of the Sudanese club, more is at the African Championship?
Well, it was not so good a start for the Egyptian club in the CAF Champions League. As the Malik was installed, as everyone knows, against Shabab Blouzdad of Algeria. Mm-hmm. And then again, it was not too much positive result against Al-Marikh or Sudan in Libya. Mm-hmm. And now with 2-3 minutes away, Al-Ahli also is conceding a goal against Al-Hilal in Sudan. So hopefully with a few minutes to come, Al-Ahli can make up the result. Back to Al-Zamalek, yes. Like what you said, Mohamed Awad was the man of the show against Al-Marikh. He did a very good job, in fact. And I just want to support what you have said in your report about Awad, with the fact that just to recall our audience that Awad played 12 matches in the CAF Champions League. Out of the 12 matches he played in the CAF Champions League, he has 9 clean sheets, which is an amazing figure. Mm-hmm. So out of the 12 matches he played, he has 9 clean sheets. The last one was against Marikh, as everyone, it was the match ended between Zamalek and Marikh, goalless draw. Mm. Yes. So Zamalek produced good performance against Al-Marikh. The match was supposed to be in Sudan, so it's played in Libya. And again, it's an away match. As Zamalek has a little chance, depending on what's happening today in the other match between Esperance and Shabab Blouzdad. So hopefully Zamalek will make up this bad start.
What are Zamalek's chances, in your opinion, in continuing in the tournament?
As we said, we have to wait for today. Mm. We will see the results between Esperance and Shabab Blouzdad. The best result for Zamalek is to come with a draw at least, so it will be in his chance. Otherwise, Zamalek from now, they have 4 matches. They have no other chance but to win the 4 matches. If they win the 4 matches, that's fine. The problem is they have 2 matches, 2 very against 2 strong team, which is Esperance and the Shabab Blouzdad, will be away. But still, mathematically, Zamalek has a chance because they have a 12 points out of the 4 match remaining for the Zamalek.
Absolutely. Finally, Mr. Abdulaziz, as you said, Al Ahli is now playing against Al Hilal of Sudan. How do you see Al Ahli's performance so far? Do you think they can make up their 1 goal down?
Well, the time may not be of their benefit. Mm. There is only 2-3 minutes to go for the match. And Al-Ahli conceded a goal, and it is very it's a fatal mistake from Mohamed Shinawi. Yes, he was available, very very much available when the Al-Hilal missed a penalty shootout. But Al-Ahli had the chance to finish off the game, to kill the game in the first half. But unfortunately, they were not lucky enough in the first half. Al-Ahli's performance was very very bad, to be honest, and they conceded a goal, and I think it won't be a good start also for Al Ahli. This is the third; it will be the third defeat in a row, but hopefully Al Ahli made it in the plus 90.
Indeed, right. I'd like to thank you very very much, Mr. Abdulaziz Abu Hamar, sports analyst. Thank you so much, sir.